stuff disappear. So if it's on, it will be shown. If it's different than one, less, then it will not be shown. So we do that in the pixel shader. This one. Okay, this is the color and this is the texture. Let's take it, put it here. This is the vec 4 color or texture. Color texture color. How do we do it faster? If it's one, show it. If it's less than one, maybe integer. Let's try. Maybe I have another idea, but this is the only idea I have. Or subtract, or I don't know. Print. Let's test it. Yeah, we have a problem. Ah, doesn't not load. Okay, how do you do it? I can do it with if, but it's whatever. Then one. Equals 0, and that's it. So we eliminate any blending. We could do that in the blending equation, but I think it's okay for now. So we could do that probably here. This equation, or the alpha one, 0 or something. Let's try first with the pixel shader solution. So you can see there is no blending now, it's very crisp. What is below 1? It will be rejected. We could do it with alpha testing also. Okay, now let's try the blending idea. How is it? So we take this out for now. Will it work? Should work. Let's check it just to make sure it's like blending. So back in the day you didn't have the and then let's take it out. So back in the day you didn't have the alpha blending, just alpha mask, that's it. Okay, so it's with blending again. And let's test with this one. So the function is okay, and the alpha is source alpha 1 minus source alpha. So this should be either 0 or I don't remember. I have to check the function. No, wait. Alpha test, kind of. Show me the function. Okay. Source alpha or what I think is destination. Okay. So we need alpha source alpha. What do I need to set? Yeah, probably just leave it like this. Because I cannot do anything in here, I think. But I could do alpha test. Just check it. Remember GL alpha test. I don't remember alpha testing, so okay, if it's GL alpha function equal, must be equal with 1, right? We always test if it's equal with 1, I think. Let's check it. And we can disable okay, it's working. This is alpha testing. Very nice. I really don't like that. I think it's because of subpixel stuff, in my opinion. Because if I do it to be one by one, let's check the render target. This is here, this is somewhere here. Okay. Let's check that frame. No. 100% zoom. This is the current zoom. Something is fishy, but it's. I see blending. Where do I see blending here? Okay. Now that is weird. Why do I see blending? Alpha? No, doesn't have any. Am I missing something? What am I missing? Alpha. Let's check the alpha. 111. This is the. Whoa, what the heck is this? I think this is the alpha thing. And with alpha, okay. Alright. I would like to have a crisper image, but I don't know why. Anyway, it's working, so it's greater or equal than 0.9. It will let a bit of blending, but we don't want that. I am just doing for testing. I let even this, it will be a lot of blending, alpha blending. Right? Yeah. So let's take it out. Greater or equal, or just whatever equal. But if I disable blending, what will it happen? It should be okay. Because it's using alpha, as far as I remember. Yeah, so we don't need blending. So we actually don't need these, we can just disable it. So we can disable blending. We do alpha testing. Alright. Okay. Let's clean up the shader. And it's clean. We'll just leave it like this. So we are adding, we are not multiplying, because if we add, we can make flashing of the. Well, we could also multiply it. Maybe it's better. Yeah, I think it's better to multiply it. It's nicer to multiply because it actually colorizes the object. So now we'll have some black shapes and red Red ships. Ilken have it nice. When it's hit, we can have it like red or yellow. And it's the game. This is just white multiplication with red, and the players are also just white color. Yeah, that should be okay. Now let's see why it has this weird. If you can, I can zoom here. Let's zoom it more to make it really big. Game. Let's tweak it here and go. Let's ramp 1000. We will check the so you can see if we move it or not. Ah, yes. So if I move here, come on. But now it's working. Basically, this is 1 pixel more here. And if I move it to the left, it is less because of the subpixel, whatever accuracy or something. How can I make it scale better? See, it's like big and scaling, so it's not really nice. Not pixel perfect as I want it. So it works. I like the per pixel movement. But this is from the, I think it's from the, let's do some tests. Let's see where we move things. Unit. When we move it. Let's just round it. See what happens. We round the float values, but probably it might not work. I don't know. And the same. The same scaling issue. See, here. For example, this has 2 pixels, this has 1. If I move it, now they are 1 pixel. Or I don't know. 2 pieces. So it's something. So I don't think this is really just it. And when I'm rendering them, I do around here, rounding. It could also be from the, let's try to bleed it but without scaling. Actually, let me run it without the DPI stuff to see if it's something from the DPI. Where are you? Oh, okay. And okay, without DPI. I don't know that we want proper sizes. Let's check the rendering of the bleeding bleed and bleeding. Okay, so the new width and new height. Maybe we should make it round. Let's see if that fixes the problem. Oh wait, this is me. Okay. No, he didn't fix it. The same. It's also around the width and height. Now you can see the weird scaling here. Some kind of subpixel thing. I don't like that. How can I fix that? But it's okay, this is good. Anyway. So what's the problem? Because it should scale it properly. I know there is no linear interpolation, but I don't think I want that. I just wanted to scale it the nearest. What is it? Let's do this. Create screen render target. Okay. Yes. So when we render, we want the let's try linear. I'm curious, but I don't want that effect. I want pixel sharp pixels. I don't want this. This sucks. It's blurry because it's, I mean, it looks, I think, without no artifacts, maybe. Or not. No, it is. Still has a problem. This is bigger than this one. So it's not from the resizing of the render target texture when we draw it to the back buffer. So it's something with the sprite itself. Let me see. So this is okay. The placement, I think the size of the quad. Okay. And that would be in unit. But this should be actually fixed. Why am I doing round? I don't need that. Yeah. 33 and 32. And this is subpixel. And what is the okay round? Maybe we don't need round, maybe we want, but wait, round 135, yes. 62. Another one. This one, for example, should be 276. Ah, okay. So it should be like. Actually, it's okay. First of all, we don't need this. And second. We need seal, I think. But I'm not sure. I don't think so. But let's test it. Oh, it's the same. I can see it here, even here. Floor, actually, but this is not done. There is something. Yeah, same. I'm pretty sure it's the same with the. Let's use where do we beat it? Beat. Okay, let's try this. With video new height, let's see, no scaling. See something? Can they look okay? I don't see no problem. So there is still a problem with the actually let me try again. Okay. So there is something with the scaling. And it's probably because of this, but no. Okay. Okay. So here is the problem, but I have to see how I fixed it, if it's fixable. Okay, let's test it again. I think it's from the there's something. There's something with the stretching of the scaling, the nearest. It tries to how can I bleed it perfectly? Let's check the this. When we have a bigger, okay, this one. So we have, this is bigger than this one. We print screen and we check the texture now with alpha. Wait, why is it not alpha? Why is my that is odd. Why there is no alpha? Okay, alpha, no alpha, what the heck? Ah, because there isn't. Because I. Ah, okay. Yeah, I got it. But still, it should be. I should see the. You know. The final image. That is weird. What? After this? Very interesting. So this should be a normal image. Why cannot I see the that is weird. Am I missing something? What am I missing here? So I do alpha test and it should be baking the color. With alpha, the ship is okay. So it's not showing the what the final image. That's strange. Because my image is final, right? It's like this. Why cannot I see it? Very strange. I'm missing something, but probably I don't know what. Is maybe is this visualization or I don't know. What is range? Alpha range or what? So I don't get it. Okay. But this is not 100%. Okay, let's test with the pixel shader. Pixel shader. Let's put back the texel color alpha is less than 1, texel color alpha equals 1. Okay, just for the sake of it. Building. Let's close it. Let's test again. Zero, sorry. Wait. Not one. Zero. Okay. All righty. This one. Oh, come on, really? What the heck? I don't get it. I really don't get it. What's the problem? Why is it trying to give me this? Because I have the final images with alpha, with whatever. It's already finished it. I don't know what is this. This is blasphemy. What the heck is this? Input. I don't know. So there is no alpha basically. It doesn't matter. Channels. This is wrong. I have no idea why is it doing that. Why? Then let's do it even better. Let's continue our charade and put back the. I should have not deleted it. GL enable GL blend. Now testing. Let's see if it works by first time. No, I have to. I don't remember it. I had some blending. Blend. Yeah. This one. Let's check it out. Okay, so this works. And let's see if it works also in this render doc. And I have no idea why is it showing the sprites with no alpha. Really. Screen. What the heck? What a heck? Why? Why is this working and the other doesn't work? But we have a nice thing here that the actual one on one pixel thing is okay, it's not stretching the whatever. And then the frame buffer, it is stretched. See? This is bigger than this one. But in the render target, it is not. Actually, let me try to zoom. Zoom, zoom, zoom. See if it's stretching it. No, it's not. So when we render in the back buffer, there is a problem. We have more pixels here than here. What could be the problem? We are using nearest. Is there anything else than nearest? We can enable this back, but whatever. Let's just keep it that way for now to visualize better the back buffers. I have no idea why is it showing with no alpha, with no transparency. What could be the problem? Because it has the clouds in the back. I mean, I don't know. It could be something from the render doc. Let me check. Render doc alpha test issue. Okay, maybe there is something. So alpha test commands your no favor triangle programs are used. Okay. I Actually, I could do the same without alpha testing. Let me do it. So we don't need GL blend. I'll try something just for the fun of it. And if our alpha, we can drop it. But is it clip or halt or I don't know. GSL halt. Stop. Stop. Discard. Okay. Let's try it. Will it work? Should work, I think. Yeah, it works. We are doing alpha testing in shader basically. So we can leave those here for now. Just we can also check if the cooling of faces is okay. Okay, let's test it. Maybe the triangles are not, but we don't. It's okay. So it's okay for now. But we can disable it. Okay, what else? We need to fix this problem with the. Let me get this rectangle out. Let's see. Let's do some testing. Let's first put this at 0. And see how it behaves. So I really want to fix that problem with the scaling. Okay, still a problem. And floor. Yeah, still with problems. I think the same with sail. Seal. It might be from the hardware, I don't know. The nearest. That could be a problem. Or maybe just leave it like it is. I don't know. Same issues. What could be the problem here? Maybe it should be multiple. So if you have should be either double or yeah, probably. Let's test this. Just a second. So probably the width, the new width and the new height should be multiple multiple or let's test it as so we had video width multiplied by 2 and video height multiplied by 2. Simple as that. And we should not have the artifacts, I think. Am I right or am I wrong? Yes, I think I'm right. So it should be multiple of. So it's either double. A multiple of the resolution, the initial resolution. Yeah, there is no problem now. They are equal, all the pixels. See here, here, I don't see any issue. Okay, so I understand now. What if it's 1.5? And this will be a problem. Yeah, this is totally wrong. It should be multiplied. So we should run the game full screen with a dedicated resolution to have perfect pixel, no weird scaling. Okay, so if I put it 3 times, it will be okay. Yeah, it's perfect. Okay, I got it. We know the problem now. Yeah, so for example, when we have it full screen, we should have a resolution of so the biggest resolution that we can fit the small window multiple of width and height. So we have like perfect, pixel perfect, with no artifacts. Okay, can we do that now? How should we do it? Well, it should be multiplied. Actually, we have to fit because we don't have vertical screens, I think. If you play the game on a vertical screen, we have to take that into consideration when we fit the image. but let's focus first on the wide screens. Okay, so the height should be can I do it in a formula or iteration? So how many screens? I don't know how to do it. I only know how to do it in a for loop some while. Okay. Let's just keep it for now like this. Now we keep it like this. We'll figure out later. I have to think on this and it will take a lot of time for me. Okay, find highest size multiple of your height to fit to the window. With the scaling. Right now we can keep it 2. This is okay. This should be fine. Let's test it. Yep, no problem. I don't see any problem. Should be okay for now. Let's test the non-DPI one. Perfect. Actually, I should maybe I have name. I don't have it. It's okay. We can test this for now. So the backgrounds will be tile maps and so on. Let's make this green. Actually, the color is nice because you can colorize them. Okay, so you can kind of fix the problem with the scaling. We'll have to go back to it later on. Unit. Yeah, this is okay, just round it. So the scaling is okay. What did I want? wanted to color them in green to see if it works nicer. Yep. Let's disable player 2 for now. We can use it and you can post the player at this position. So, okay, just one player. Just one player and we place it. Transform position at game. No, this is the game, right? Okay. Graphics video with alright, and the Y position video height -64 or something like that. Ah, I know why. So the position is somewhere here. So we need it if we want it perfectly at minus sprite. We load it first and then we use the sprite instance. The sprite and the frame width. So we basically put it exactly at the middle. What incomplete class sprite? Okay. Sprite. Okay, no problem. So it's exactly at the middle of the screen. Exactly. From here to here. So it should be like 120. Okay, perfect. Now we need some weapons and some projectiles. But we have to take care of other things like sound. Maybe get some sound going on. And we should also press escape to exit game. Let me do it right now. And the rest will do it in so when we press exit. I think we can do it. Can read here if controls of let me make some nice function for this. Input control. This can be even in line return controls, attitude control. And here if is control down, exit and exit game. So we will have like menus and whatever, but for now just exit game. And pressing escape should exit. Perfect.